Hi there, I hope you have a lovely day. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Tana. So today I have the update for the project, that 70s project pen. This is a project created by CC here and Kim from Teacher Loves Beauty. And this is a project to pay homage to the 70s. And the project started last month on July 27th. It goes until July 27th next year. So it's a year long project. We have to give monthly updates, and the creators of this project recommended to start with 7 items and then roll in as soon as you finish one item and so on. So I picked, I think I have 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 7 items, actually 7 prompts, but not 7 items in total. So let me explain like this. So I had number 1 rolled in. Number 1 was linoleum floors, something with a pattern. And for that I rolled in 4 blushes, which I wanted to use each 5 times. I did that, so let me get started with the first one. So this is from Catrice, the It's Wine O'Clock blush, you know, with, and you can see here the pattern, right? So I used it 5 times, this little guy, and I used from the same line, this is a blush box, it's called Blush Box, this one. This is the shade Dolce Vita. It's more you know, more a peachy toned blush. If you mix everything together, of course, right? And this one is more like a berry shade combination. And then I pulled in from Essence, from the sister company, this little guy. This is All You Need Is Pink, so more pinkish, right? And again, you can blend all these shades together. And final one, this is, it's the Berry Connection. Also use it 5 times, therefore, because I finished this prompt, I have to roll in a number 1, so just for your information. Then number 5 was lava lamps, something liquid or neon. And for that, number 5, I pulled in this foundation from ColourPop. It's a no filter foundation in the shade, let me see, what was it, medium 100. And I wanted to use it 5 times. I used it 5 times, therefore this one also rolls out of this project. Then I had number 16 in. Number 16 is Push Button Phone, something with a pump. You have to push it to make it work. And I put in this e.l.f. Mineral Infused Face Primer. It's a typical silicone primer, and I want to use this little guy up. So far I used it only 6 times, therefore this one remains in the project. Now the next 3 prompts are 38, Strawberry Shortcake Scented Product, and I pulled in this Kiko Milano bronzer. It's called Sweet Biscuit, because these special edition bronzers and blushes and so on, they have a scent to them, so therefore, you know, from Kiko Milano, so therefore I wanted to use this little guy 10 times. I have not used it at all, so this one remains in the project. Then I have number 55, the Brady Bunch, something a sibling gave you or reminds you of a sibling. So I pulled in this little guy from Paula's Choice, because I recommended this product to my sister and I believe she has it as well. And this is a perfectly balanced foaming cleanser, and the goal is here to use it up. I have not counted how many times I've used it so far, but I can feel that a good amount has left the bottle. So, and then number 63 is Kung Fung K-Beauty, J-Beauty, or Made in Japan. Made in China. Why I've said no, Made in Japan is funny. So Made in China. So I pulled in here this little guy from Makeup Revolution. This is the Baked Blush in Hard Day. And yeah, I kind of use it as a kind of finishing powder, you know, because it's not really a blush shade for me. I wanted to use it 5 times. I only used it 1 time so far. So there you go. Now, as I have 2 rollouts, I need to pull 2 new products. Let me pull up the Pretty Random app then and put in the number 70, because we have to work on 70 items, right? So let's see. 23. Okay, 23. And 7. Okay, so I will make a break here and then bring the products that I've picked for the prompt. See you in a bit. Hi there, I am back with the new products for the project That 70s Project Pen. And let me read out the new prompts that I have here. So that number 7 says, huge TV, something large. Remember we had the huge TVs and then they were kind of bulky to the backside because I don't know how you call this one, the big part, not the, we say Röhre, it's like spiral or something like that, you know, tube. Anyway, so they were quite big. So in that sense, I picked actually this little guy from Kiko Milano. This is a bulky palette, in my opinion. This is a Kiko Milano one in a million holiday jam palette. Let's use this little guy 10 times. Million. 10 times. You have seen it, I think, already in other projects, you know, so because of its bulky, you know, yeah, bulky packaging, I really want to use this little guy up. You know, it's not quality wise, it's very good, you know, but it's more like the packaging. It could have been just a flat packaging, you know, not this kind of, you know, how do you call this one, hexagon, you know, not hexagon, is it six squares? So yeah, I really want to have it out of my collection. So 10 times use for this little guy. And then number 23 says pod chairs, a comfy product or something you use to pamper yourself. So just to have a little bit break from makeup products, I decided to pull in actually a perfume. This is from Carolina Herrera, the 212 perfume, right? She has this, you know, connecting piece in the middle, and then you have these two glass bottles, you know, stick together. So this is 212 one side, and why not use this little guy up, you know, and then be done with it. So that's one side, not both sides, but the only one side. So number 23 would be Carolina Herrera. So 212 perfume use up. So yeah, that was my little update for the project, That 70s Project Pen. I hope you enjoyed it. I see you in the next update. Have a good day. Bye bye.